First of all, when you wanted to prepare for this examination, this interview, you should understand that in general, we could see only three types of persons. Number one, there will be a person who will make things happen. Secondly, there will be a person who will wait for things to happen. And thirdly, there is a person who will wonder what happened. So these are the three types of persons in general you'll come across. And now, the Union Public Service Commission will have to select one belonging to this three category. So naturally, UPSC will select whom? UPSC will not select a person who will wait for things to happen. Right? UPSC will not select a person who will wonder for what happened. So naturally, if we wanted to get selected, we have to become one who will make things happen. The suitability of the job will have to be born in your mind. And UPSC is using a method to assess your suitability. And this method in general is called as interview. But you should understand that interview is not a new method developed by a public service commission to assess the suitability of an individual. This is a very, very, very old method. Even before the writing form has evolved, people were using this interview to make judgments on others. So interview is not a new method. Interview is a very, very old method. Even before the evolution of a written language, interview was there to assess the suitability of a person. Now, how will you assess? How will you assess? You can assess through two broader ways. So, assessment of suitability, your suitability is assessed by what? By an interview. In general, there are two ways or there are two methods of interview or two types of interviews. One interview is a structured interview. And another interview is an unstructured interview. So the suitability of you is assessed by interview, and there are only two types of interviews. One is a structured interview, another is an unstructured interview. What do you mean by a structured interview? All applicants will be given the same stimulus. And they will measure the response of you. Same stimulus is given to people and their responses will be observed. It will be measured by the interviewer. For example, the interviewer will ask the interviewee that why you wanted to become IAS. Same stimulus and the response will be measured. So why you wanted to become IAS? This question will be asked for everyone who is, most of the students, candidates will be asked this question, why you wanted to become an IAS officer? And the response will be measured. Right? The second type of interview is unstructured interview. Unstructured interview is administration of different stimulus to different persons. The same question will not be repeated to every single candidate who is coming to attend the interview. Different questions will be asked to different persons because different persons have different distinctiveness. Different persons have different circumstances. So, this is what is called as unstructured interview. This will be the type of interview most of the time you will be experiencing in civil services examination. Unstructured interview. The questions are not prepared before you come to the interview hall, because it should be a person specific question, a situation specific question. A situation will be asked to you and you have to respond to the situation. And that situation will be dependent on your specification, on your qualification. They'll ask something which is very special in you. So, you have to prepare for an unstructured interview. You can't just ask a student, a candidate who is coming out of the interview hall, what question was asked to you, so that I will also know the question, I will also answer the question, I will also practice answering the question. So this is not going to happen 99%. The questions asked to the earlier candidate will not be asked to you because you are different from the other. Now, it is not just your headache to present yourself best before the board. It is also equally a responsibility of the board to act as a good interviewer. It is their responsibility to ensure that the interview is a good interview, which means that they will ask questions. They will ask questions without any bias. Then only the interview can be a good interview. They should ask a question without any bias. And they will not just listen what word you have used. They don't only listen to the answer of you to make the interview good. They will check the answering of you. So it is not just an answer, it is answering. It is not what you say, it is how you say. It is not just about how you say, it is about your non-verbal communication as well. For example, a good interview or a good interviewer will try to assess your emotional state. He will not only go by the words which you are speaking verbally, he will try to check the emotional state of you. What is your facial expression? When a question is asked, what is your facial expression? From the facial expression, from the voice of you, from the pitch of you, from the tone of you, from the posture of you, from the gesture of you, they will assess what is present inside you. So you will find that there will be a candidate who will come out of the interview board telling his friend that I have answered all questions. 10 questions were asked by the board. I have answered all the 10 questions. But when the score comes, he would have got 130 or 140 out of 275. This is because he has given the answer verbally, but he has not substantiated the answer or justified the answer using his non-verbal clues, using his internal state, he has not answered. If you ask me what is interview, Interview is the inner view. What is the view which you hold inside your heart? What is the view which you hold inside your mind? That view is what is expected to be told by you. So you can't basically cram an answer. You can't by heart an answer in the name of interview preparation, because the answers will have to come naturally. That is why you'll see that when a student is saying that I wanted to come to civil services to do social service, the same answer is given by two people, A and B. A will get a good score than B, even though they have said the same answer. The reason is this, that A has given his inner view and B has given just an answer which is textually prepared by him, memorized by him. So you are not just a device which will record things and it will reproduce mechanically. So what is the soul of this interview preparation is inner view on any topic will have to be presented by you. It has to be molded by you, thought by you.